gitu. Pekerjaan udah lama di sapi berapa lama, Pak?
Kerja sapi ada 25 mungkin.
25 tahun ya?
Iya.
Gimana, Pak? Menikmati kerjaannya?
Kerjaannya, ya alhamdulillah. Kalau ada sapi, sekarang kan tarikan susah. Itu ada sapi, panjang hidup aja.
Tidur, kurang tidur gitu, Pak?
Kalau kurang tidur, Pak, syukur lah biasa.
Biasa. Nemenin suami ya, Bu?
Masuk kita.
Tahun berapa mulai ikut suami? 10 tahun. Senang, Bu?
Senang lah, namanya ikut suami.
My name is Daryl Hassan, and I am the general manager here in Tokyo. The live export ban in 2011 brought tremendous damages to our business, but not only to our business, but to the lives of our workers. SCAS was introduced, and it made our job way easier. We are now able to control and monitor all of the abattoirs and the feedlot in our supply chain more transparent and easier.
Nama Pak Yakub. Saya kerja di sini udah 30 tahun. Saya bagiannya tuh pengiriman, pengatur-ngaturan mobil, ngirim sapi, terus pengaturan bangunan juga. Itu pekerjaan saya semua. Nah, di sini adanya namanya BPS, bagus buat masyarakat. Kita juga karyawan nggak ada ngambil dari mana-mana, kebanyakan lingkungan sini. Nah, ini putri saya yang kedua. Dia pun kerja di sini. Udah generasi kedua.
With the implementation of SCAS, we became more reliable in our traceability, and our company is proud to uphold the highest level of animal welfare values and compliance to SCAS. The high standard brought a positive impact not only to our business, but also the industry as a whole. TUM, in two of our locations, we employ around 400 to 500 workers on a daily basis. Most of them have been working for us for more than 20 years, with some of their children currently already employed by us. They are given trainings on a regular basis on handling of animal to ensure we uphold the highest standards of animal welfare in both our feedlots and abattoirs. To ensure their welfare, we also try to provide homes and motorcycles for our senior workers. As our business grew throughout the years, we are happy to give back to our workers and the community. We slowly move them from their wooden houses to concrete houses that we built nearby our feedlots and provide them with healthcare. As our business grew, we feel that we have more and more people becoming reliant on our company as their main source of income, underlining the importance of import of Australian cattle.
Isi, Bu.
Iya. Ini di TUM kan, ini tinggal di sini sama bapaknya sama anak saya 3. Terima kasih TUM sudah bisa membuat keluarga saya seperti ini. Di sini senang sekali. Bisa menyekolahkan anak saya sampai kuliah anak saya di sini.
Ya, pemilik RPH Petir yang di supply chain oleh feedlotter TUM dan BPS, ya, memotong sapi ex Australia sampai di angka 50 ekor. RPH kami ini sudah berjalan di 10 tahun kurang lebih dan mempekerjakan 62 orang. Kami membuka RPH ini adalah turun-temurun dan kami adalah generasi kedua. Saat ini RPH kami mensuplai 23 pasar tradisional yang itu terbagi di Jakarta Utara, Jakarta Barat, dan Kota Tangerang sendiri. Kelebihan sapi Australia yang saat ini kami potong adalah rasio tulang dagingnya itu sangat terpenuhi di tingkat pengecer kami dan pedagang kami di pasar tradisional.
TUM believes that paying attention to the welfare of our workers and their families directly correlates to the welfare of the animal as well.